You're focusing on me as if you're awake. How interesting. Not that you can do anything about it, even if you were somehow awake. Even as I glide my hand down your cheek, down your neck, and all the way down your chest, you're powerless against me. Mortals really are only able to defend themselves in the waking world. How pathetic. Are you trying to speak with me? I can see how desperately you're trying to move your lips. Are you that afraid that you'd put all your willpower into trying to bargain for your life? I suppose, as the only one who's ever bothered to try, I will allow your attempt. I've released control over your mouth. Now, speak. You think I'm cute. I'll admit, I wasn't expecting you to use flattery to save yourself. But it's an interesting attempt all the same. Oh. Changing your words now. My, I commend your bravery, but calling me as beautiful as a goddess isn't really what I'd like to be known for. I am a demon after all. Yes, a demon. How else would I be able to get you in such a state? You didn't think an ordinary mortal woman would be behind this, did you? If so, you truly are foolish. Better, I hardly see how being caught in the clutches of a demon would make this situation better. You like the powerful types. I fail to see how that is relevant as I'm sucking out your life force. You like that? Mortals are more confusing than I remember. Before, all I'd have to do is plague their dreams a little bit, then get them in a state of uncertainty of whether they were in the living world or the sleeping world, and appear to them in this form, and then they'd be mine. Well, a part of their life force would be anyway. It's quite simple, and yet you seem to want to confuse the process by talking. I'd assumed you'd only wanted to bargain for your life, and I haven't had a chance to speak with a mortal in quite some time, so I thought I'd indulge you. But here you are, speaking odd phrases about appearances, and telling me your type, in which I can only assume you're talking about romantic attraction. Are you okay in the head? Are you perhaps the kind of human who does not care when faced with danger and merely seeks to have a laugh? Or do you really think you have a shot at wooing a demon? I have to admit, it's an amusing idea, but given your attempts so far, I'm afraid you might have to step it up, mortal. Eyes as dark as the bottom of hell. That's certainly a good line. More in touch than your goddess attempt. Well, where's the next? Or can you not think of any more? Set your body free. I can't do that now, can I? As much as I am enjoying what you're doing with those lips of yours, I still need you to remain my prey. I can only live if I have your life force after all. You'll give it to me willingly. Someone has. Beautiful as me, deserves all the life force humanity can offer. That would be a dream for a demon like me. And to hear it come from the mouth of a mortal. I must admit, you're better at this than I thought. Perhaps I'll be nice to you. I'll release your left arm and hand. Would that be enough for you? Or do you think you can only flatter me with pretty words? Very well then. Your fingers and then your elbow. I've given you back full control. How do you feel? I see it's your turn to brush your hand against my cheek and down my neck and down my chest. Repeating my behavior. I'll admit, it is somewhat intimate. The more you get to know my body, the more appealing it gets. You really do have a way with words. Immortal. Have you ever run into a succubus before? I'm sure the two of you would get along wonderfully. Perhaps that's the fate that awaits you after your mortal coil has been shed. I highly doubt someone who would be so eager to praise a demon ever has a chance of getting into heaven. Which means that, if not a succubi, you would still become one of my demonic companions in the future. Given how much you've amused me, perhaps I'll be nice and recommend you to the head of the sleeping demons. You seem to like me an awful lot, so I'm sure you'll like the rest of my kind as well. I'm the only one you have eyes for. That mouth of yours never runs out of things to say, does it? Well, I'd like to see what else that mouth of yours can do, if you don't